Now I want to discuss with you about the cubic polynomials. As very much aware you are that the any cubic polynomial has its form like ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d provided a is not equal to 0. This is the cubic polynomial. It is a cubic polynomial. Its degree is how much? Its degree is 3. If its degree is 3, how many zeros it has? It has, or a cubic polynomial has, 3 zeros. What is meaning by 3 zeros? It has 3 values of x which can make this result as 0. So, if I ask you how to calculate, the method is very much possible that first of all, the first 0 will be obtained by using remainder factor theorem. Remainder theorem, factor theorem's concept we can apply to make the, to obtain the first 0, and then with the help of that 0 we divide and we will obtain a quadratic polynomial, and then 2 more zeros of obtained quadratic polynomial can be obtained. Now I want to tell you, if there are 3 zeros, alpha, beta and say symbolically gamma, what is the relation between 3 zeros and these coefficients? The 3 relations are alpha plus beta plus gamma is minus b upon a, then alpha into beta plus beta into gamma plus gamma into alpha, it is positive of c upon a. Then third relation is alpha into beta into gamma is minus d upon a. As a cubic polynomial has 3 zeros, so it has 3 relations between the coefficients and zeros. And in previous case, quadratic polynomial has 2 degree 2 zeros. So there were 2 relations, sum of zeros minus b upon a, product of zeros c upon a. It has 3 degree 3 zeros, so there are 3 relations. That is alpha plus beta plus gamma. That is sum of 3 zeros of any cubic polynomial is the relation minus b upon a. Then sum of zeros taken 2 by 2. That is alpha into beta plus beta into gamma plus gamma into alpha is what? Positive of c upon a. Then product of all 3 zeros, alpha into beta into gamma, is given by minus d upon a. So if any cubic polynomial is given, then you can find or estimate or verify the relation of zeros and the coefficients. Similarly, as you have been doing the problems in verification of your problems of, that is, quadratic polynomial. So this is something about what is a polynomial, algebraic expression having special kind of form, a0 plus a1x, as earlier discussed with you, then types, then degrees, then zeros, then something how to calculate, how to obtain and how to establish the relation between their zeros. So this is something theoretical part, and without this depth of knowledge you cannot move further, because at every step you need to use these relations and these concepts. Now I will definitely discuss with you few more problems to elaborate, to discuss, to tell you the detail or depth of the problems of the type. Now I want to discuss with you few problems that how to obtain the zeros with the graphics. It is like this. If I take the first example, this is the first part, as I indicated here, how many zeros are there in this first shape, in the first figure. You can say it has none of the zero, because the line, this line is not intersecting x-axis at any point. If a line or a graph or a curve can intersect x-axis, it means it has some zeros. And as many zeros it has, at as many points it is intersecting. So here you can say this line is not intersecting the base, that is the x-axis, so it has no zeros. If it has no zeros, it means this is the graph of a constant polynomial. Here you are noticing that this graph is cutting our x-axis at two places. So it has how many zeros? It has two zeros. If I tell you about the third, A, 1, 2, 3, and it is separated here like this, and I can remove. If I remove this part and you observe only this one, then you can notice 1, 2, 3, 4. It is intersecting it at 4 points. It means x-axis. So you can say this graph has 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 zeros. It has how many zeros? 4 real zeros. And if you notice here, this is also not cutting anywhere. So it does not have any zero. So we can say that as many points are intersected by the curve on x-axis, that polynomial has same number of zeros.